All right, so Peter, what about an amnesty? Is it a good idea, Jeremy?
The driving instructor from the people that took their 12 lessons, if the driving instructor has an input on it, this person is capable of driving. You know, there is some people that after a couple of even after 12 lessons, might be the best driver. So there has to be some sort of a
grading system.
Yeah, back then there wasn't as many cars on the road when Charlie Hutton done it, when he was on the back of his Charles Lumpkin horse, whatever he was in.
Our gun runner.
It was a whole different story back then, but what happens, even down in Kerry, I know a lot of country people and young fellas are into that sports cars and all, and if they don't communicate with the people that give them the lesson, I think it's a big no. But if they're communicating and the fellows that said, look, they've done 12 lessons and they're capable of driving, well, then give them a light.
But the instructor might not remember everybody, you know what I mean? Because you have to remember it's been 2 months now since anybody was getting driving lessons.
So
the instructor probably does, 15, 20 people a day.
So when you think of when everything gets back to normal, you have to think of the safety when every road user sounds about deadly.
See, I understand what Ely Ray is saying. It's difficult at the moment for a young person who's done his lessons and maybe they need a car for the job. And they get a way of getting this out there, and they can't get a license. But they go out to the road and the guard stops and says,
"Where's
your license?
I don't have one." And he's heading home there.
For this line, thank you.
You're welcome.
It is
difficult.
He's
saying
an amnesty,
but who's going to
help him?
He's
going to
administer the amnesty
in these offices and close down the first place. Exactly. And then, if people get the view, then
you've got
to
learn the lesson
down
the back of the car.
But
that's what happened in 79.
Yeah.
There's 25 to 50,000 people. Now, most of those people in this country are quite old now. But 20 to 50,000 people got driver's license, full driver's license. Never sat behind the wheel of a car, it was great. In those days, there was no photograph on a license and no date of birth on a license. They were quite vague, the information on a license, and you could get away with murder.
I only got rid of the paper license, I think, about 2 years ago.
Sure, I knew groups of lads who used to drive bikes and they had one driver's license. And they just shared. They were asked, you didn't have to have your license on, you were told to produce within 10 days. So if one was asked to produce it, should they just use the license? And the guard didn't know who he was. Yeah. I mean, there's no picture on the license. But there is now, that's what the author can tell James. It was very vague in those days. But let me go to Matt, you're on Classic Kids. How you doing, Matt?
How are you?
Matt, I understand what Ely Ray is saying. You know, I wrote, no qualm of what he's saying. I don't know whether this is the right way to deal with it or not, because, it is difficult for young people, particularly, who are waiting to get a license, and now they can't drive. So what are they going to do?
Well, I tell you, Ely Ray, you say to yourself, they stand up their own listeners, and that's it. They don't care about the rest of the country.
But that's their job, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. You have to. You can't hold on against them. Think about it. Have you ever driven around, Kerry? Have you ever driven? I mean, bloody God, it's bad. Every time a special bus driver around Kerry for years, and every second worry is all these skid marks, the road sticking and things, and all this from this boy right. Have you ever been down there for the rally of the lake?
Right, okay.
God, the guards are overwhelmed with all these boy riders, and then to add unqualified drivers into that makes me mad.
Right, so you think this would be a disastrous idea?
He made a genuine thing.
He made a good argument for fairness.
He did, but I would say the best thing to do would be to give the... You know when you have trackers in that car? If he wasn't for work, day three, the tracker starts, they start working 9 o'clock. Tracker starts from travel time to work. Then the travel time home, and that's it. Then that's fine. But letting them out on the
like road, a curfew, so to speak, so they can only drive it when they're only to use for work, but not after 9 o'clock at night, or not for socialising, or any other reasons.
Absolutely. Until this crisis is over,
it's a bit unfair because it's not their fault they can't get a license.
Yeah, but these are the COVID times, this is unprecedented. So
I love that word. That'll go down in the end of this year is the most commonly used word. So well. The most commonly used words will be social distancing and unprecedented times.
Unprecedented.
Or uncharted territory. That's another good cliche. Everyone's using that one as well.
Yeah, sure, look, we've got equipment that we shouldn't have. Shane Ross was...